Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I was recently contacted by a Ukrainian team that sells on Amazon that offer these carving kits. I think they've got four total. The Christmas tree and Santa was the newest one, and I think they've got a rhino, a giraffe, and I think an elephant. But anyway, they contacted me and asked me if I would do a review of the product, and I said sure, send me the Christmas tree and the Santa since that's getting close to Christmas time. So yesterday it arrived, and this is the packaging that it comes in. A bunch of different information, what it is, wood carving kit for beginners, Santa whittling kit. So overall the box presentation's very nice, so I figured we'd open it up and take a look at it, and then test it out a little bit. Okay. Step-by-step manual. Wow. A lot of detail there. It doesn't look like it'd be too bad for a beginner. Now, I'm not quite sure if I would actually carve it that way, but that's okay. Okay, so there's the instructions for the Santa, and then the instructions for the Christmas tree. Okay, here's what they've got. We've got a rhino, an elephant, and a giraffe. And then there's some different carving kits there. There's a spoon carving kit. Okay, so we got that. Comes with paint to paint it, some polishing compound. Looks like the pencil's broken there, but not a big deal whatsoever. And a little piece of leather to strop the knives with. Okay, very good. Some basically, I call it, it's vet tape, but carver's tape. All right. Got some hangers for the ornaments, little eye for the Christmas tree or the Santa one. Oh, there's another one in there. Okay, so two eyes to put into the carvings, and then some hangers for them, a couple of band-aids. Looks like chip carving knife. Didn't feel too bad. Yeah, it's kind of sharp. We'll find out when we put it in a piece of wood. And then looks like a regular, just a wood carving knife. I think the description, these were, I'd have to double check, so don't quote me on that. I'll double check before I make mention of it, but it's got a little plastic blade cover over the end of it. Didn't feel too bad right off the bat. It's got the NEWURBAN logo on each one of the blades. So we'll test those out. And then looks to be, well, this one appears to be basswood, but this one, it feels like basswood, but I've, this could be the half some with some grain in it. Okay, so we will lay out the pattern for maybe the Christmas tree or the Santa Claus. And so overall, very impressed with the packaging so far. Seems like they've thought of just about everything that you would need, from the hangers to, hopefully you don't need the band-aids, but to the carving tape, paintbrush, paints, leather strop, and some honing compound. So not too bad. We'll see how they carve. I briefly just kind of tested the See how sharp the knife was on a scrap block of wood and not the wood that came with the kit. And I think I want to go ahead and put some compound on this. This is a feels like a piece of rubber with a really nice piece of leather on it. See how that does. So I looked at the book just real briefly for the tree, and doesn't really seem like it's going to be that difficult. So let me go ahead and lay the pencil lines in there. I'm not going to show that on camera because if you order the kit, you'll have the instructions right here. So I'll go ahead and lay that out and come back whenever I start actually rounding this thing off. Okay, so I got the lines drawn on there according to kind of what you can pick up off the instructions. This block of wood is 1 5/8 by 1 5/8 by 4 7/8. And so I kind of mismarked my line there, but you can see we're gonna connect those corners. So the next step they talk about is just going ahead and rounding this off. So from the bottom up to the point until you get it to the shape of the picture. And so something like that. The knife seems to cut fairly good. Was really kind of surprised based on, this big bevel that we've got there, but so far it's not too bad. Now basically, this is just a kind of a rounding exercise. Obviously we're carving with the grain on this. Got a little bit there, but we kind of know what we're the general shape that they're wanting you to try to get. So what they've got, flip back here to the back. So as the this is start cutting the block edges to form the cone shape. So you're going to keep working that around until it says please check your results as on the image. So that's a lot of removal, which is okay. I mean, that's kind of teaching you how to round things off. So I think what I'll go ahead and do is work on that. Probably won't show all of it on camera. If I do, maybe it'll be a fast forward type of deal. So let's see if we can go ahead and get to this cone shape that they're showing in the book. Okay, well, I kind of got it to the shape, and I can tell you that it did take a little while. That's quite a bit of wood to remove to get it to this stage. The knife did cut it. Although I did find myself whenever I was cutting it a lot was that I really wanted to choke up on that so I can get a full pull as I was going through here. And so in doing that, this knife handle is not, really comfortable. But for somebody that's starting out and just learning how to do this, it's not awful. It's not horrible. It will cut and it will do the job. So the next step that they've got in here is to draw the lines around the tree. So we'll just do that real quick. They don't really give you any recommendations on spacing. I guess it's just left up to however how you want it to look. So we'll go ahead and kind of mark these. So now that we've got the lines marked, they're showing you to switch over to this knife, which I assume that you can use that knife or you could use this one. But we'll go ahead and do kind of like what they've got here. So this is the tree trunk. Down there. So we'll go ahead and switch over to this knife. So they're showing just making a stop cut all the way around it, basically. Got that? And then they were cutting up towards that. This knife's not doing too bad. So you would just continue that all the way down. So I'll go ahead and do that and let you know how it turns out when we come back. It's not doing bad. I probably will go ahead and put this knife on that strop for just a real quick tune up and see if that makes any difference to it. So, but otherwise, not so bad so far. We'll come back when we get a little bit more carved. Okay, so I've got about 30 minutes in this project. There's some cleanup underneath there that I'm gonna have to do, but so far, the knife that they're showing, which I would consider this like a chip carving knife, that's what it looks like to me. It does a fairly decent job of allowing you to make that scoop motion to give the tree some definition. So the last thing that they show on there is they were coming in here and just making some cuts in here, some randomly along each one. So I would imagine that's using the same knife as just a series of V cuts, something like that, to give it some definition. And then after they went around there, they put in the eye to be able to hang the ornament, and then they used the paints that were supplied in this kit to paint it. So overall, I mean, that was a kind of a fun little tree to make. The Santa Claus looks like it would be pretty good too. I'm not going to carve that one on camera. I just kind of wanted to do the tree to show you and kind of give you my thoughts on the kit. For the price, I like the kit. It gives you everything that you need to be able to get started if you've not ever done any type of carving before. Not a bad value. I didn't use the tape because I've got my own glove and thumb guard, but I could see where this would be okay. I do use it. Got some on my thumb guard there, so I do use that tape. The paints look to be like they gave you enough paintbrush to be able to paint the tree. I paint a little bit differently. I thin mine down a little bit, but with water, whenever I paint, but I think you probably have more than enough paint to be able to do that, to paint those. So hopefully this review helps you. Not a bad kit, actually. I was shocked. I did have to strop this knife again about halfway through. It seemed like it was getting a little dull. Now maybe it could be the piece of wood. I was having some difficulties down here in the base of the tree. So I hit it with the strop again, and it seemed to be a little bit better. So just load this strop up with some that compound and keep it sharp if you notice that it starts to kind of drag in the wood. This knife here, I didn't really have any problems with it. After I put it on the strop, it seemed to stay fairly sharp, other than, you catch yourself wanting to choke up on it quite a bit to be able to make some of those cuts. But overall, a beginner's carving kit, very good. Hopefully this helps, and we will see you next time.